Well, when CBS decided to cancel the drama series Jericho last May, fans protested by sending, listen to this, 40,000 pounds of peanuts to the network, and it worked. Executives put the show back on the schedule, so please welcome the star of Jericho, Skeet Ulrich.
Hi, Skeet, how are you doing?
Nice to see you.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Thank you.
Were you aware this was happening, these peanuts being...
I thought you meant that people were going to be here. I was sort of aware of it, yeah. My mom keeps abreast of all that.
Do you think it really had an effect on the executives?
I think it clearly had an effect,
Can you tell me why peanuts were sent?
Well, in the season finale of the first season, it was a rally cry to a war, essentially, for our town versus a neighboring town. Mm-hmm. And it's a cry back to the Battle of Bastion, where one of the American colonels had said, nuts, in reply to surrendering.
Yeah.
So we brought that back, and so nuts became the rally cry for the show.
That's so great, the power of people.
Yes,
I know. The power of nuts.
I think that's it, and the power of
Yes,
nuts.
Of course, let's get the nuts there,
I smell a nut campaign.
You know, Skeet, I probably have asked you this over the years, but I can't remember. The name Skeet.
Yes, yes.
Are you a country boy from North Carolina?
I am, yeah.
And where did Skeet come from?
It was a baseball coach gave me the nickname. I was small and fast and...
A skeeter, in other words?
Yeah. It started out as that, and and then I switched it. That's my only say in the name.
That's so great, though.
Yeah, but since I was nine, they've called me that, and then my family started calling it, my friends, everybody, and... My real name's Brian, but somebody could yell it on the street. I would never
Brian Ulrich. No, Skeet Ulrich.
Yeah, Skeet,
gets your attention.
You
right?
are. It suits you.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
So, how is your twin boy and girl?
They're amazing.
Yeah,
they're incredible. They just turned seven on Sunday.
Great.
Yeah. And we had, you know, we decided not to do gift bags because they always sort of get thrown out, you know, nothing. So we did gift CDs of, like, their favorite songs and stuff like that with a picture on the front. And my son wanted to sign all his CDs. Which was, you know, kind of daunting.
Let him do it.
But it was a great time. They're unbelievable.
What was their party? Did you have like a special...
This was the first time we had two different parties because they had been in the same class for so long. So we could get by with one party. Now they have two, they're in different classes.
Sure, they got to have all their girlfriends and all his boyfriends.
Exactly.
At that age, right.
So yeah, we did a bowling party and a...
Good
and
idea. Great idea. Bowling party, yeah. We're going to take a break. We'll come back and talk some more about Jericho. Skeet Ulrich from Jericho on CBS. You know, it's a post-apocalyptic drama.
Yeah.
Most of the major cities in the United States have been wiped out by nuclear explosions, and yet this small town and several others remain.
Yeah.
And you're the sheriff of the town, trying to keep everything
Yeah, I've become sheriff through this season. Yeah.
Right.
It's been an incredible experience, I have to say, and especially with the nuts campaign like we talked about. But just the working environment, I mean, we all get along so well, and really, I mean, that was... One of the greatest things about being brought back was knowing we would come to work together again with each other, and it's been a unique experience.
So you made all the Jericho fans happy, right?
Yes,
well,
I
let's hope
so.
Hope it goes on another year to keep
them.
Yeah,
that would be great.
Or the nuts are going to start flying again.
That's right.
We're not through with those nuts, CBS, you know what I'm saying?
We tried to work cash into the season finale for this one.
Well, let's take a look at you in action here. Now, he's the sheriff at this point, trying to deal with a crisis. Take a look at Jericho.
Major! Tell the other squad to get moving. We'll rendezvous in 30 miles.
What is it?
There was a shooting out at Richmond Farm.
I heard from Getz already.
What'd he say?
Said he went out on J&R business. Someone opened fire on him. Killed three of his men.
You believe that?
You know something I don't?
There's a survivor. Or she's unconscious, but when she's gonna
be... So we're ready and standing by.
I'm sorry, Jake, I've gotta go.
Where are you going?
20 minutes ago, a pipe bomb went off outside the J&R office in New Bern. Took out six of my men. I'll be back in 12 hours.
It's not going to wait 12 hours.
Well, it's going to have to. Things are coming apart at the seams in New Bern right now. And you have my word. Tomorrow, I'm going to get into this. But for tonight, I'm trusting that you can keep things under control here. That means Getz is off limits. No threats, no retribution, no exceptions. Do you understand?
He's not going to listen.
Jericho, tonight, 10 o'clock. TBS. Well, good luck, Skeet. Great to see you again, buddy.
Good to see you.
Good luck to you.
Great to see you.
Hey, the pizza maker's back in just a moment.